$1 million in prize money is on the line in the first ever head-to-head autonomous racing event to be held at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway in October. UVA Engineering's Cavalier Autonomous Racing Team will compete with other top universities for bragging rights as the best autonomous racing team in the world. Buckle up as I, your host, Chris Tyree, and UVA Engineering Professor Madhur Behl take you in the shop, under the hood, and around the track in this new world, pushing autonomous vehicles to their limits.
The Indy Autonomous Challenge is a historic event where university teams from all over the world will compete for $1 million in a head-to-head, the first ever autonomous race at speeds of potentially up to 150 to 180 miles per hour here in the racing capital of the world in Indianapolis. University of Virginia is one of the teams that will participate in this historic race come October 23rd. The challenge came about to be roughly about 2 years ago when ESN, Energy Systems Network, which is one of the main organizers of this challenge, with support from the state of Indiana, invited academic universities and leaders in the upcoming and exciting field of autonomous racing to put their heads together and see what can be done in terms of pushing the frontier and the limits of self-driving cars. And what better way to explore those limits and really test the limits of AI and control and robotics than head-to-head autonomous racing with multiple cars on the track that has never been attempted before. In many ways, being a roboticist and being someone who works in self-driving technology, I look back to more than 15 years ago in the DARPA Grand Challenges, where they invited universities to show, is it possible to race autonomous vehicles through the Mojave Desert back in 2004, 2005. And that was a historic event which actually led to the entire industry of self-driving cars and autonomous vehicles as we see today. In similar light, I see this challenge. It's the grand challenge in what's next in self-driving cars. Motorsport has always been the proving ground for safe and upcoming technologies for the automobiles. In the beginning of the 19th century, the general public was skeptical on the safety when Ford introduced the first ever automotive car. How safe is this thing? Is it going to stop? Is it going to brake properly? And to convince the general public and, you know, build their trust in the technology, we introduced motorsport racing. In that same spirit, I think we need a similar challenge. Would I be willing to, you know, put my loved one in a car with no driver and have it drive my kids to the school or, you know, fetch my parents from their homes to my place? Most Americans today would say probably not. I would say 3 in 4 people are skeptical and don't trust this technology. Therefore, we need a similar challenge, but this time, not so much in the hardware, because we've gotten that right, but in the software. The modern self-driving car is nothing but an iPhone on wheels. It is totally governed by the algorithms and software of self-driving. And that's exactly the whole goal behind the Indy Autonomous Challenge. If we can demonstrate that we can write software and algorithms which can race these full-scale cars at high speeds in close proximity of each other at a racetrack in a safe manner without crashing, then it is bound to have a significant bearing on the safety of self-driving in general. And therefore, in many ways, we are operating at the frontier of self-driving car industry and pushing the barriers in terms of what is possible in the algorithms, in the perception, and the planning, and the control methods which go behind any self-driving car operation. So let me touch upon why racing is an ideal way to push these limits of safety of self-driving technology. If you look at what is happening in the automotive world today, almost every major manufacturer has a self-driving car program. They are testing prototypes of their vehicles on public roads. And we've even had some really unfortunate incidents where people have lost their lives because, you know, we have unproven technology being tested on the roads. What makes self-driving harder is the unknown unknowns. The kind of things which can occur on a freeway, in an urban environment, traffic-wise, is very difficult to predict. You can predict some incidents, such as, you know, we always have erratic drivers who will switch lanes at the last second. And therefore, it is easy to design algorithms, relatively speaking, to handle those situations. What makes self-driving difficult and challenging are the edge cases. Sometimes the shadows cast by some bridge overhead may look like fake lane markings on the road, and the car may try to steer itself because, you know, it thinks there's a lane here, but it's just a shadow. And for a human, it's very easy to deal with these kind of situations, even though we've never seen them, but computers are very literal. The approach today is, let's drive millions and millions of miles on real-world roads in simulation to get more confidence on situations that may occur. But no one, including myself, can ever claim that we've seen all possible situations, and that's what makes the last 10% of self-driving 90% more difficult. So where does racing fit in all of this? Well, here is a crazy idea and a research hypothesis. Racing, if you think about it, allows you, by design, to have edge cases appear more often. By design, in racing, you are driving at the limits of control of the vehicle. You are driving in such close proximity to your opponents, and that's exactly what you need in terms of the readiness and the capability of a self-driving car. So imagine if your self-driving car had some kind of an agile mode or an agile controller that could immediately take over when a collision was imminent or when something unexpected happened, and it could understand the limits of driving, the limits of traction, the limits of steering and braking of a self-driving vehicle. We are not doing that kind of testing today with regular self-driving prototypes. And so racing is a means to explore these limits of control for self-driving in general, to design algorithms which understand the physical dynamics and the capability and the traction of the vehicles. When it matters most, the car should have the ability to brake aggressively, to steer aggressively, and get you out of the fix. Everybody today is teaching their cars to remain on the road, whereas with racing, with this agile controller on top of your regular driving stack, we are teaching cars to potentially go off-road in a safe manner when it matters most. So that's why these big challenges, these big holes and gaps in regular self-driving can be, to a large extent, filled in or complemented over and overall enhance the safety of regular self-driving if you have this experienced driver, experienced race driver in many ways, part of your algorithm stack. The reality is that what makes racing attractive is that subconsciously we know that these drivers are operating at a different level. They are literally putting their lives on the line. They are in control of how the machine operates on the track. So that's the thrill of racing. And, you know, the entire world of racing is centralized around the personalities of the driver for the right reasons, I would say. However, that doesn't preclude autonomous racing from being exciting, but in a different manner, right? So racing is a team sport as much as the focus is always on the driver. I would argue that our driver is the brainchild of the students who have been programming the software stack. And let me just dwell a little bit upon what our driver is trying to achieve. If you ask any racing driver, they will tell you that they drive with instinct and with feel. Many of these drivers, almost all of them, have been racing go-karts since they were a kid. So they have developed muscle memory and experience and instinct for things like, is my car operating at the limits of its traction? Am I going to oversteer? Am I going to understeer? Is the balance of my car off or correct? Is the front brake bias heavy or not? Does the aero need adjustment? There's a long laundry list, and it's instinct and gut feeling to them, and they can communicate over the radio to the team, which makes the adjustment to tune the car to their liking. Also, these drivers are instinctively good at analyzing complex situations. So they have gotten good with assessing how risky is this maneuver of overtaking? When is a good time to overtake? Is my opponent going to make a mistake at this corner? How do I plan my overtake 3 laps in advance and gradually work towards that? This is all second behavior to them, and they do this continuously with precision without thinking about it. And we are trying to replicate that in code. And if you are an engineer, if you are a computer scientist, someone who likes machine learning, engineering, or STEM in general, mathematics, what could be more exciting than trying to code this artificial intelligence driver to mimic this experience and instinct and feel of a real expert human driver? It's a very hard challenge, right? So make no mistake about it, multi-agent autonomous racing is highly difficult, unsolved challenge, and that's what makes it exciting for the viewers, right? So you are looking at a car which is driving by itself. There's no control, there's no remote control handling the car. It's completely on its own, making decisions based on the data it sees and trying to characterize all these different aspects of racing as an expert driver would. And that to me is as exciting as having a real driver push the limits of the car. I think after this race, this Saturday, installing drivers will have a whole new meaning in the world of racing itself. It's a testament to what we can do today in terms of technology, where STEM has taken us. And it would be a token of inspiration to anybody looking to get into STEM, into computer science, into engineering, that this is what you want to be, this is where you want to be at, compete with the level of human expertise and advance AI for the betterment of mankind.